was by far the most played concerto in the 19th century. And, you know, everything which came after Chopin, Liszt, Schumann, Brahms, Tchaikovsky, Rachmaninoff, Grieg, you know, all these popular piano concertos, they are dealing with the same sort of heroicism which you have in this concerto. Actually, the soloist is being thrown out on the gladiator stage here from the beginning with these huge passages. And it's very much like a statement like in the Greek concerto, you know. The Schumann, or, you know, here I am. You know, that came from Beethoven. That came from the Emperor concerto. I find it very hard with some pieces of music, and this second movement of the fifth concerto is among them, to imagine a man sitting down writing this music, because it's like it's always been there. And it remains so hauntingly beautiful, always again and again. And this idea, you know, a lot of people say that Beethoven couldn't write melodies, you know, just because he was a master of putting together motifs and creating great structures out of that, doesn't mean that he couldn't write a melody. I mean, this is the most beautiful thing I... What a melody, and what heartbreaking harmonies to go with it. That lasts forever. I mean, to know how isolated he was at this point in life and how he had discovered really the seriousness about his handicap. He couldn't play this piece. That must have been such a feeling of failure. And then this music, that is so touching. There is never, for me, a trace of self-pity in Beethoven's music, even with that difficult a life. This is a piece that my father loves very much, and when I was little, he would play for me an LP that we had, and especially he was crazy about the transition from the second to third movement, which is very special. You know, it dies down. Very calm. Sort of lullaby-like version of the theme, and then from B major we go to B flat. Where are we going now? A new theme is being introduced in like a dream. That's incredible. Thank you. can wonder why he didn't write more piano concertos after this one. I think the main reason is that he couldn't play anymore because of his deafness. He couldn't play this concerto. It was the first one, the only one he didn't play himself. And then also, what do you do after a piece like this?